Chris Brown. What's up, man? Hey, I just wanted to come to you by way, obviously, of a video, and it is certainly my prayer that this video makes its way to you somehow in the future. Today is 03 April 2011, so we'll see how long it takes this video to get to you. Man, I too, like the whole world, heard about anyway, and saw some pictures of the whole Rhianna thing. And man, I want to tell you something. I just want to talk to you for a little bit about some things. And the first thing I want to tell you is that, man, and this may not make sense now, and maybe it will. You cannot let what you did, you know, your mistake, destroy you. And why do I say that? I say that because the whole world, you know, jumped on you. And I said this also in another video to someone else. It seems like the whole world will love you, but just a short time later, and when we slip up and do some things we don't have any business doing, those same people who saying, oh, he's great, oh, he's this, oh, he's that, those are the same people that turn on you, and the same people that'll kick you while you're down. And even Oprah Winfrey got in on the Chris Brown bashing. She said some things, and you know, Oprah, you know, one thing about Oprah Winfrey is she'll say one thing, but if you wait long enough, she'll say something different, which makes her a hypocrite. She, her whole 25 years of show, the show she produces is all about making a change, living your best life now, overcoming your past. Yet she said some things about you that are just not keeping with the very things that came out of her mouth. And you know, that's okay. But man, you cannot let what happened, man, destroy you. Why am I just now being a Johnny Come Lately? I'm being a Johnny Come Lately because I've just been seeing some things on the news, and certainly not getting to a place where I say, oh, everything they say is true. But man, your persona, your aura is different. Your aura has been different ever since that thing with Rhianna happened. And you know, I watched a short video clip on YouTube of you breaking down at some awards show. And certainly those things happen to us, man. Those things happen to all of us. I just want to share something personal about myself. So listen to this, old man. Some years ago, I was very much involved with someone, and it was one of those things where in my selfishness, in my ego, in my arrogance, I just walked out on her. I just walked out and left. And by the time I came to my senses and realized that what I'd done was going to cause me what I call future heartache, it was too late. You know, the Bible tells us that which is crooked cannot be made straight. And that can mean a lot of things, but one thing that you have to accept, man, and not let it tear you down anymore, and not let it eat you up anymore, is there some mistakes that we make in our lives that just cannot be made right with that other person whom we've made that mistake against, or who was involved in that mistake, man. What we can't do is allow bitterness to set in. And I am not certainly saying you're bitter at Rhianna or anything like that, but what I am saying is it is apparent to me, and I don't even know you, just watching who you were with, who you seemed, the road you seem to be headed down, that one mistake, man, is driving you to a place where you just seem to be unrecognizable. And I'm sure that you look in the mirror in the morning and keep asking yourself why. You can, you know, people will tell you, they'll come to you and say, well, you need to get over it, get past it, keep your head up. That's not enough. What you have to, at this time, focus on is accepting that that thing happened, man, There's no going back. There's no changing it. It produced a scar in your life. And listen to this. You may have scraped your knee. We all scraped our knee, cut ourselves. We've done something. And even when that wound heals, it scabs over and it leaves a scar most of the time for the rest of our life physically. The same is true, man, with the spiritual or emotional mistakes we made, and we make and we'll continue to make. There are things, man, that all of us do that have just really messed up a relationship, and there's no way to go back and make that right. Well, Rhianna, there's no way, obviously, to make that thing right. Are you too cordial? Maybe. But you cannot allow that one scar to affect the rest of your life. Bitterness is setting in, man. It is like, and in all honesty, it just appears to me as if since your aura changed, it seems like, man, you're losing your mind. For what? Everybody, Chris, has done something. You know, and I, the preacher, have done things in my past, and I brought those things forward to my present at that time, and when I did that, it affected, man, the future victories that I would have in Christ Jesus. So what I'm telling you is refuse to keep that wound open, that whole Rhianna wound open in your life. Let that thing scab over. Let it heal, Chris. And then all you can do is keep on going. I'm not going to say, like most people, get over it. Again, there's some things we do that are so bad that it affects us for the rest of our life. I walked away. And even today, Chris, 15 years on, that still affects me, man. And it's not so much, and you'll probably understand this, it's not so much, oh, I wish I could go back and change the past. We can't do that. That's not what it is with this old man that's standing before you today. What it is with me is I know that the Bible says, be sure your sins will find you out. And our sins are like what you did, find us out through regret. But we cannot let that regret change the whole course of the rest of our lives and keep us from our purpose. What is your purpose now, Chris? What is your purpose now? Okay, this Rhianna thing happened. Okay, the wound is still open. Let it heal. Let the wound heal. I can't tell you how to do that, but I will tell you, you need to let that wound heal third. What is your purpose, Chris? You broke her heart. She broke your heart. However that happened, man, you cannot lose your mind here. You can't do it. People say, oh, Chris Brown is on a comeback tour and all of this other stuff like this. And even those people like Jay-Z called you a dead man walking. They called you a dead man walking. And people like that, I noticed some things and just I follow certainly people that struggle, not just famous people, but people in my own circle that struggle. And one thing that I've always noticed about this, and this goes to my Jay-Z comment, is when somebody has the gifting that you have, there are people that are jealous. There are people that want to see you fall. There are people that just want to kick you down. And Jay-Z is probably one of those people. Who knows why? But I thought that comment he made was out of sheer jealousy. I thought Oprah, the comment she made about you, was rank hypocrisy. Chris, pick yourself up, man. You know, the multitude of tattoos, maybe you're still getting them, maybe you're not. Man, you can't cover up what you are. People cover their bodies with tattoos because they're trying to hide something, Chris. What is it that you're trying to hide? You cannot hide things, man, in your heart that need to come out and that you need to deal with in order for you to heal, in order for you to go on. Yes, it hurts. Yes, you want to take back and it's not going to come. Yes, people jumped all over you. Yes, people did all of these things. But what are you going to do to stand the test, man? Are you going to walk in your purpose? And your purpose ain't to be out here doing the things that you're doing now. They're not. Your purpose is not to freak out when people ask you about the whole Rhianna thing, man. You can bet for as long as you breathe, somebody's going to bring that up to you. A much smaller thing. Look at Allen Iverson, man. No matter where he goes, people will say this, man, you talking about practice. You remember that comment? We all remember that comment Allen Iverson made. Chris, I'm begging, man. Don't let this destroy you, young man. Don't let this take your mind from you. Don't let that hurt you feel turn into bitterness. Then you turn around and be mad at the world. Yeah, some people hurt you during this thing. Some people that you thought liked you or loved you turned on you. But all you're doing at this point, man, is ushering into your life future heartache. You're gifted. Your gifting ain't to be singing and doing all of that, doing all this worldly stuff that you're doing now, man. You have purpose in God, Chris. Nobody's going to tell you this because they want to bask in your celebrity. They want to be around you. They're not going to tell you the truth of the matter. Sure, there's a few people that tell you the truth of the matter. But man, you have purpose. You're an ultra-gifted dancer. Use that to dance before the Lord, Chris. You're dancing before the world, and now you know the world hates you. Sure, they hate you. You do something else, they're going to turn on you again. That's the way of life. But young man, get past this. Let the wound heal. What wisdom did you gain, Chris? One thing that I found out about wounds when they heal, the Lord Jesus allows those wounds to heal in our life when we depend on Him, Chris. And those wounds and the wisdom of those wounds are to be passed on to others. You can buy your Lamborghinis. You can pimp those Lamborghinis out. You can buy your mansions. You can be what we used to call an 80s truck down excessive. You can have all of this stuff. But at the end of the day, right now, you're miserable, man. What are you going to do about that misery? What are you going to do about those wounds, Chris? I'm going to tell you this. Listen to me. Listen to somebody that maybe not, certainly I have never been a superstar, but somebody that's dealt with what you're dealing with right now. Listen. I read something in the Bible, man, and it says this. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, Chris, that whosoever shall believe in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God didn't send His Son into the world, Chris, to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. Chris, give your heart to Him, man. You can sing gospel songs or Christmas songs or whatever all that stuff is you want to, but you were in desperate need of healing. Psychiatrists can't do it, Chris. Your entourage can't do it. Your fat bank account can't do it. Your Lambo can't do it. Your jewelry can't do it. Become the man right now, Chris, that the Lord wants you to be. Take this, what I'm telling you, man, and talk to the Lord Jesus. Heal, Chris. It's time to heal, man. So be it.